Yes, welcome to the Jamaica Young Police Channel. To our loyal viewers, subscribers and Patreon members. At the channel, we are a group of law-abiding citizens who believe in the rule of law and respect the rights of every citizen, but not the ones who do not subscribe to such behavior. We do believe in and support preemptive strikes because they save lives. This is a logical conclusion because preemptive strikes save lives and prevent the further loss of lives. We are all about saving lives at this channel. We at the channel aid criminals with a passion and do not want them over here. We do not want your views, your subscriptions, your likes or your comments. Please go elsewhere where the red carpet is waiting for you. Over here, we want you to go to prison or the departure lounge at Madden. Moving on to today's video. You know, we have always told our loyal viewers and subscribers and members of the Patreon squad that whenever we are doing a video, always look at the LCD. And right now, you look on your LCD, you will see where it says Buju Banton drove fear into the heart of Donovan Jermaine. Remember, it's Donovan Jermaine is the man who's responsible for his stardom, for wherever Buju Banton is at this time in his life, because that's the man that built him. But you know, you have some people, you know, some people, they don't remember where they're coming from and they have no loyalty. And their loyalty is just all about money, and no love. And that's, you know, it shows that this man is the epitome of evil, wicked. You know, so as you're going to hear, as we have told you before, that Buju Banton owed this man some money and he had received it. And, you know, we told you already, you're going to hear. And, you know, when Buju Banton, he rode a motorcycle to the man's house where he shot and killed a dog. Buju Banton had bought the dog, you know, for Donovan Jermaine's son, you know. That goes to show you how evil this man is. But most of you who are Buju Banton's fans do not know half or a quarter of this man's character, apart from going to prison in the United States of America for coke dealing. Yeah, remember that? But Buju Banton went to prison in America for coke dealing, and the other two men that were there with him, you know, apart from the informant who set him up, the other two men, them, you know, they make a plea deal with the government and they testify against him, and these men were Jamaican too. So that goes to show, you know, as much as they said that they are they're willing to commit crime, but they're not willing to go to prison. So, you know, they turn around and testify against him because he was the one that was on video tasting the coke. You understand? And pretend as if he was innocent and he was set up. He wasn't set up. The man is a notorious cocaine dealer from the 1990s. And as we told you before, along with Frankie Sly and Wayne Wonder, they were all involved in it. When I tell about allegedly, we are telling as a detective. You understand? We're not going to delve anymore. So, you know, so in this eye-opening video, where we delve into the lesser-known aspect of Buju Banton's character, while many of his fans are unaware, this influential figure's stories go far beyond his infamous imprisonment in the United States for coke dealing. Prepare to be shocked as we uncover the sinister side of Buju Banton, revealing him as an evil, wicked and impulsive individual. In a spine-chilling incident, Buju Banton instilled fear into the heart of Donovan Jermaine, yes, forever altering their lives. Riding his motorcycle, a trail bike, to Donovan's residence, and an unthinkable act occurred. Buju Banton callously shot and killed a dog he had previously purchased for Donovan Jermaine's son. This shocking revelation exposes Buju Banton's true nature as the dark side of his personality come to light. And guess what? It was his license gun that he used to kill the dog, you know, but no one reported him. That goes to show, you know, this man operates as if he have immunity from prosecution in Jamaica. So that's why he was able to just kill the dog like that. Or who do such thing? So join us as we bravely confront the reality behind this public figure, mask, persona. Discover the depths of wickedness hiding behind Buju Bantan's facade of charm and talent. Note, we share this untold story to shed light on Buju Bantan's complete picture, to provide transparency and understanding. Our intention is not to defame or attack him, but rather to initiate a discussion and encourage deeper exploration into the multi-dimension nature of public figures. So we are not here to defame Buju Bantan. We're just telling you to start a conversation. So stay tuned for more shocking expose and revelation on our channel. So as we continue in this exclusive video, we delve deeper into the shocking scandal surrounding Buju Bantan and his dog's pregnancy. Yeah, you know, we are talking to Jamie here, boy, him dog, you know, get fat up. So unveiling the truth behind this jaw-dropping event, we expose Buju Bantan's dark side, revealing the extent of his hatred towards his neighbor. On God's earth, you as a Rasta man, you are going to eat your neighbor. What kind of, you know, love in your, well, as we say, you know, Buju Bantan is not a Rasta name, it's a dread. Yeah, dread, I want them wicked in the art. You understand? Remember the one them back in the 70s, they are the original road boy in a Rasta. Like, Ranking Joe. Yeah, them say Ranking Joe is a man who started the gun business in England. Yeah, man, a Rasta, you know, that's what them say. You understand? And I just saw it go. So witnessing the distressing account of how Buju Bantan's dog became pregnant by his neighbor's dog. This unexpected outcome led to an utterly detestable act committed by Buju Bantan himself, taking his dog to the vet for an abortion, driven by pure animosity and hatred toward his neighbor. So the man dog, his neighbor dog get his dog pregnant, and the man took his dog, you know, Buju Bantan took his dog to the vet. I met them about the dog. Boy, I tell you, one man can't wicked someone. So such callous behavior once again reinforce his true nature as an evil man. So join us as we examine the motive behind Buju Bantan's despicable actions and discuss the consequences faced by innocent lives involving the scandal. This thought-provoking video shed light on the disturbing reality of a man so consumed by hatred that he would go to the extreme length to harm not only his neighbor but also his beloved pet. While we expose the dark side of Buju Bantan, let us reflect on the cruelty and heartlessness exhibited by this man. So stay tuned as we reveal the untold details and explore the aftermath of this shocking incident. Don't miss out on eye-opening revelation. Watch now to discover the entire story behind Buju Bantan's dog pregnancy. So share your thoughts and opinion in the comments below. So, you know, this captivating video, you know, delve deeper into the alleged car stealing scandal involving reggae legend Buju Bantan. And a shocking con, and, you know, along with a man known as Danny Fisher. So as we uncover the unraveling events surrounding this jaw-dropping incident, prepare to be blown away. Amidst the intrigue, we learn that Buju Bantan was allegedly implicated in a car stealing ring, where the unsuspected victim happened to be his Chinese girlfriend, Kim. So Buju Bantan, based on information received, you're going to hear it for yourself, you know, from the intelligent officer's mouth. Buju Bantan was involved in this alleged car stealing ring in Jamaica, along with this man named Danny Fisher, and robbed his girlfriend, Kim, the China girl, at gunpoint. And the story takes a chilling turn when an individual forcibly take her car, leaving her in a state of distress and shock. So you're going to hear how that happened. However, the twist in this tale comes when the perpetrator realized their mistake and are compelled to return the vehicle to Kim. Revealing their guilt, they offer apologies to rectify the situation. So that way I tell you, you know. So it was an emotional roller coaster experience by those involved as relationships are tested and secrets are unveiled. So through meticulous research and analysis, we aim to shed light on the truth behind this scandal and provide a balanced perspective on allegations made against Buju Banton. We intend to present you with an objective account of this shocking incident, leaving you informed and contemplating the complexities of human behavior. If you are ready to be captivated by this thrilling revelation and gain comprehensive understanding of Buju Banton's alleged car stealing ring scandal, then buckle up and join us for this eye-opening journey. Stay tuned for more thought-provoking content on our channel, and don't forget that we make blog videos about corrupt politicians, corrupt police officers, corrupt judges, gunmen who are parasites to law-abiding citizens, and the criminal rights group, because we believe that corruptors and murderers must live in fear of losing their lives and freedom. So if this is the first time to the Jamaica Young Police Channel, yes, we highly recommend subscribing to stay updated with our latest content. Hit the subscription button above, click the bell icon and select all to receive notification. Remember to give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful and informative. You can join the Patreon squad. Yes, by doing so, you'll gain access to exclusive content that cannot be played on YouTube due to various restrictions. To unlock this untapped collection of videos, click the link in the description box below. Joining our Patreon community allows you to explore content that complies with laws, rules, and regulations while avoiding disruptions to our channel functionalities. So thank you for your continued support, and we look forward to providing you with exceptional content. We at the Jamaica Young Police Channel are dedicated to educating you and informing our audience about issues that face our beloved country, Jamaica. Our mission is to inspire and encourage you to unlock Jamaica's true potential. We believe that knowledge is power, and by spreading the awareness, we can regain control of our country from the 63 individuals who have repeatedly failed us. One thing you can count on us is the truth and nothing but the truth. And we must continue to spread the truth without fear or affection, malice or ill will. And you know the truth hurts and the guilty. So, moving on. So, you're going to listen to the conversation that we're having with this intelligence officer who used to work for the Jamaica Defense Force back home in Jamaica. You watch, you listen, you decide.
Numerous to mention. It's so bold-faced, it's so daring that you have to wonder sometimes when you see it, you have to wonder if it's actually real. You have to wonder if it's actually happening in your eyes. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Because I see many times men get charged a major crime and before you even leave the station, they look, you see them men outside. And if you follow them and watch them good, the people when you see coming to pick them up, you have to shake your head. You have to literally shake your head. You understand?
True.
Because it's so bold-faced and daring. You understand?
A true man.
Remember about that school in there, they have this police that them called Pinchers, you know.
Oh, at Portland?
St. Thomas in the day first. But then if you get in them,
one brown police?
Eh?
In brown?
Yes, man. They end up they end up they kill him down at Pinelands.
Yes, man. I know how we are talking, man. The boy, he must
expect it. Yeah, man. I almost told him to get
a pay trouble in music, man.
What me say from, remember, I telling you that the man a police from me, I go to high school.
Mm-hmm.
And no, I'm not in a cadet and them things, so I have an intelligent brain from them time there.
Mm-hmm.
And just the men them when me see.
He must criminal man.
Just the men them when me see my hang out room, because I used to hang out with some, you know, a place I sent them a same call, Dumfries, you know, so I pay a good man come from them place there.
Mm.
And the man them used to see my hang out room and summertime when me used to see them man there.
I carouse, man.
One time I see him, I just said, you know, as I look at you with juvenile like school, and he just make a yell because he used to, you know, when he get the name, he remember when Pinchas come out with the little glasses. And
yeah, man, the transparent glasses, he used to wear no fight.
Right. Right. The man used to wear every day and him end up calling him so. And one day I pass him, I yell him, and the man called me and said, come here. Stand up in front of me. That name is not for you, no. That is for my fans and my girls.
What?
I'm going to look back. Good.
I know, I remember my old fat name and everything. Then we kill him on the football field. Like, you understand? I all corals, man.
Yes.
Dirty boy. He wasn't nobody and everything.
Before I said it, even change the name.
Mm-hmm.
Who want him in our dragnet? And I remember my face, but he probably think me and him got training school or something. Mm-hmm. I'm left from Police Angleton soldier something.
Yeah.
You don't remember me. I said, yeah, I remember you. Yeah. I remember you, but I remember you the way they said to me.
You're called Corrosion.
I'ma walk and leave him. I mean, I tell you, say, when I say change to Special Anti-Crime Task Force, again, we go up on a giant military patrol and the man hold him again. Because the man hold him at 38 with a 38, I mean, I don't know what the man get to. I don't know if he need to go to court, if he need to get bail or what.
Boy, I'm...
Second time when Pusey would have killed him with liquor, McFarlane.
Mm.
Remember that inspector named McFarlane, a big fat one who looked like Ox?
Yeah.
They would have killed him with liquor. Can I actually drop the gun that day, you know? You understand?
I remember, man. I remember him correct name on him to
me. I will go back up on accident quarters again and him ask me the same question. And the only thing, I remember, I didn't know him name them time. I can't remember his name now.
I don't remember him correct name, but I know him brown and him face broad.
When I listen to news, I hear, I say, yes, man. You're not going to be so lucky the third time.
Mm.
Three strike that.
Yeah, man, I kill him, kill him on the football field over Appian Avenue.
Man was like a pest, you know.
Yeah, man.
Because all the second time when I'm old, the people might rejoice, you know. The second time when I'm old, the people might rejoice, don't they? I never forget the day.
Him kill all the youth where him and him train together, you know.
Eh?
Him kill all the youth where him and him train together upon one bus. One police, you know.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, man.
I even know that. But some of the people them rejoice the day when they used the man dead.
I'm
going to hold the man the second time.
Kill a youth, man. A power 15 bus.
People must say, yes, him now get to this time, yeah.
Mm.
And him did get back out. I don't know what I tell you. As I tell you, the system corp and him are one of the greatest examples I use.
As all corrosion.
Understand? One of the greatest examples I use.
But him did have the back in a Porsche and them things they still do, you know.
Eh?
Him did have the back in a Porsche, man.
Yeah, that remember Payne Lance, that is the thing.
Him come from Mackay Lane and them things there. So what did happen on them things? Him did want to run Mackay Lane and Payne Avenue. So him and one boy and him. The same brother where you tell me Walker man. I walk a man them did kill him up on the football field. So you know about Budge Banton and the car dealing, the car stealing, caring were involved Danny Fisher and Bigger Ford.
But I got, man, tell you. So the night, and if I give it a Friday night, then. But the woman, when they put my balcony the night.
That's how into. Hold on, wait it. Before you go, Lana, when the woman Buju married to Africa, and him, Fimbi, no 5 feet in Lana or Fim?
I don't 5 or 6. I think one of Lana Fim is not Fim, but in the take her, the first girl is not Fim.
Oh, so, but him take the picnic, say a Fim and him thing there, like Bob Marley.
Just like when you see Bob Marley, they take Rita picnic.
Yeah, boy, me, I tell you, saw them woman are dangerous, man. She and the man, they take and she go. And yet still, you know, them want people put them on pedestal like them on nobody, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So, the system is that every Friday is in the day room. And my get a call boy, get a call. You hear me?
Yeah, mommy, I hear you now.
You know, my girl named Kim. Name Kim.
Oh, that's a female girl, that.
I'm gonna put you outside, man. Yeah.
Oh, that's a China girl.
Huh?
That's a China girl.
Yeah. Half China, but she more look like China than Negro. And she red and she have the pretty hair and everything.
Yeah.
She call my wife and tell her what happened.
Yeah.
So we rush and go for her and we pick her up. And she come home now and she call him.
And tell her say him get right.
My wife phone and call him and tell her say, Mark, you know, some men just rob me and take home a car. It was an Honda Civic. And he asks her what them look like and asks her to describe them. And she tell him. He tell her, I say, go back, mate. Go back, mate. And we jumped in on the car and drop her back. Then we did it for about 5 minutes. Man, I don't think it was 5 minutes. All this. And the boy then come and drop the car and apologize to her.
So I go them use a rubber of the car?
Yeah, man. Go them use a rubber, man.
And that
block them block her when they come.
And that nothing reported to the police?
Must say, she get back the car. And everything, you them apologize to her. The youth them apologize to her. Understand? And the same girl, a couple months or a year before, if it's not 2000, it's 2001.
Yeah.
Because that incident happened 2004. Yeah, I think that incident happened 2004.
Yeah.
It was 2004, I think, with the carjacking, but about 2001, what happened is that he come back to Jamaica for the first time since 1994, I think. And it was 2001, and we end up with Stone Love anniversary.
Yeah.
And in Budget the performance, Stone Love anniversary with
that's how you see him from Sweaterfield.
No man, my other brother. Yeah. I said, now you know. I have 7 brothers and 12 sisters, you know.
By your father?
I'm a mother, only have 3 children.
Oh, okay. Your father is a bad man.
Yeah. So, them to come and perform an anniversary with them foot damage. Them end.
Who would you want?
Because them end up now. Them end up. God, you go pick up Lana and go with Kim in the car.
That's how I see him when I'm rob.
Huh? Yes. It was Lana vehicle and So she said, Mark, who is this? Cool, no, 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 sir, you are the queen, she's the princess. I land a big, she knows she has a cigarette in the pocket, so she brush in the pocket. One stop straight in her, crack it.
You know me?
Yeah.
Oh, that's the time when I'm saying I play football and injure him, I lied, I'm not tell.
I lied, put it in there, yes.
I lied, I did stab him.
She did stab him in her knee. Yeah.
But a man wicked man, a man, man lie, man. So I remember the time when I told him to put your band and say injure me and all them things.
Yeah. Oh, she did stab him in her knee, man. I don't know about, I don't know about no football. Yeah, man. So, when I tell the man about, when I tell him, because they remember when they charge him for the weed, and yeah, then they end up,
yeah,
lose the firearm temporarily.
Yeah, man, I brought him with me, dad they charge him, PC dad.
Yeah. But,
and Lucius Thomas, he not try to get it back for him.
Okay.
You know, Lucius Thomas a friend though.
Yeah, I remember, I said PNP hierarchy. And then, him the one for blame Bama.
Who's Bama?
That's a Bennett man, Detective Bennett from Canton Springs, TIV man.
So why man for blame him? Why man for blame him?
Because, remember, him did lock the gate, you know? Remember, him did lock the gate, and I saw Ronnie Babylon boy move on the gate and start a cuss and thing.
Yeah, remember.
Bama go over the fence. Bama go over the fence. But why him did lock the gate? Him there try to give the man them enough time
to move the weed.
To remove the part of the ganja them. But Bama jumped the fence. And they were saying to me, one, 10 minutes, no, two it is. They were saying, man, you're going to kill Bama. But that was just probably worth that. But he couldn't, you know, if he tried that, he wouldn't be alive today, you know. If he tried that, he wouldn't be alive today.
So, you want to kill Bama?
Yeah, that's how it. That's how the word was on the street.
So we have to kill him.
Yeah. Because, and me wouldn't take it because Mama is not telling my cousin. Mama is not telling my grand uncle's sister. And then from a partner now. This is my version from a little youth or girl. Toms, I don't know if you remember him. Then up a Kingfish and I don't know him then, a long time I don't hear from him. A detective named Toms.
Yeah.
The man Bama was partner. From on them, they always get chance to it. Together, I can't remember, Bama did the half of GCIB and tell him about Constance being CIB. Until Toms, then split up when Toms go Kingfish. That's why, man. So, but then you sell it called son, but the thing about it, the China girl was okay with him. Having Lana, but she wasn't okay with nobody after she.
No, call that true Lana and give my damn thing there.
And then you have a little Rasta brother used to over the student over Carla named Booba. If Pujo pissed, him tell him, you know. Yeah.
So what? So the China girl ever have no youth for him?
No, not that. When, because even when we disappear that she sights, because we made it end up move from Carlisle. Geneva and I picked the female at the time. I don't know if after.
If she have known female after.
During them time, no. Every little thing me used to ask her all the questions, so I know that she always want to get rid of Bama and thing.
Mm-hmm. You
understand?
I want dangerous weather, man.
Yeah. So I think Bama start to move with content, some of them get bigger and start their own alliance because Bama they live in Oakland.
Mm-hmm. Start to move on Bounty Killer them.
Yeah. And them get big, so him becomes untouchable in a Buju range.
Mm.
That was on because for years, you know, she say him always start about standing. It's a man that could take it in other side. The man was able to infiltrate him and set him up, you know.
Yeah, man, I'm licking, you know. Oh, you know, no man yeah. From Adam, I know, from plane. I saw Uncle Sam, nab you, know, because I didn't know, so you're involved in a drugs thing. You understand? Put man from plane directly beside you. You understand? And you know, no man from Adam, man, I tell you about drugs, and because you, all you think about is money, you know.
Money, yeah?
Yeah, man, you know, I think
about some money. All I think about is the money.
Yeah, man.
You understand?
Yeah.
You're done in an industry where if you talk too loud, you make millions. What more you want?
No man, greed man. Remember say a long time he might do it.
What more do you want?
A long time he might do it. A long time he might do it. So
the
that's
first
why
house you get in your, the first house you get in your life, a man just drive up and get a key and say this is your own.
Mm.
Understand?
That wasn't satisfying enough for you.
I'll show you the man, curb. You know I'm wicked. You know, say, if you were German, 200,000 US.
Donovan German, that I'm going to bill him.
A manager here, I'm going to bill him. If you were German, 200,000 US. And a man owe him 350,000 US. The man owe him 350,000 US. The man send the 350,000 US come get Jeremy.
And Jeremy take fee money out of it.
And Jeremy take fee money out of it.
And the man kill Jeremy.
Hold on. So the man call him and say, if Jeremy send the 150 go give him. And like the man call him and say, yo, you get it 350? And the man say, no. And when I get 350 or 150, man said, no, I 350. So I'm call Jermaine. And Jermaine said, yeah, I 350 the man said, but remember, you owe me 200.
Mm.
You know, so Buju did buy a pump it dog, when I look at dog, them get Jermaine's son. And the man jump on the trail back and right go by the yard and shot the dog. Man shot the dog when by get a little boy.
Them should have with the license gun or illegal gun?
With him license firearm.
So they never report him.
Yeah. But tell us, come back up to Germany and they trade about you at one point.
Hmm.
Understand? The same child girl again tell me say, oh, like next door. Would you have one of them big breed dog and like him see the dog a breed and him ask him the same one named Booba said, go home to the dog and Booba was at him said the next door neighbor dog come home and go over there and breed the dog. You know same man send the boy go the dog take a wash and
why? I saw eating next door neighbor.
But say the man corrupt and wicked and dangerous.
My.
Yeah. When you talk to Sebastian's sister, you're here for yourself because I'm going to try to look back for the number.
Mm-hmm.
You know, one of them phone them, but what she send it to. You know, I'm going to look back for the number and one of them phone them. When you talk to her, if the man evil. And it's not about politics, a lot of people just don't know the man.
No man, them.
A lot of people just don't know the man, a lot of people
Because I live with a woman
in Jamaica, you know.
Lana, yeah. And go Africa go married to her next woman.
And go Africa go married, you know.
Mm.
And when the woman confront about it, you run for gun. You have five people with the woman and you run for gun to go shoot the woman.
So what mean I do? I kill Lana and claim self-defense?
I don't even know how to kill himself. I'm just saying, I'll kill her and probably go scot-free.
Because he did have a licky police in my conscience when I'm pocketing it, except that the one named Dad. I saw that Dad not get no promotion in my inspector, you know. I know, Arkansas crime chief, you know, can't move, you know, because of that case there, you know. The police lock him up, you know, say my inspector, in the reach of further inspector, you know. Yeah, man. Unwritten judgment, man. How dare him fill a cup with your banter and anything there? You never know that?
No, sir. I never even know that.
Yeah, man. Me and PC Dad, man. Philip Dad. You understand? Because them try everything, you know. Them try everything for bribe him, you know. Lucius Thomas. Them better before him become commissioner of police, you know. Them try everything for bribe him and anything there. And it couldn't work across there, so. You don't know. Them put him out there and anything there.
You know, when you see you so do, I tell you, sometimes you just doing at some unique place.
Mm.
Sometimes I used to call out some of the man them and say, yo, we just pick up something, you know. And the man them say, when them come and check, man, man them say, but all in our work, I investigate, all in our work. I say, when in our work, I see on your ears work for you too, you know.
Mm.
But all in it, I can make your ears work.
Yeah.
Understand? Because some of the men, they made that interview in it probably 3, 4, 5 years before them.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a time I could have silly come on work with, you know, because depending on where you are, you know, trust certain thing. You just decide to, you are going to work today, you don't want a man to go with you.
Yeah.
All right, can I do that? But anyway, I sit down one day and go wash my car and almost become the Patrick Henry.
Mm-hmm.
And we hear myself. But it's a coincidental, you know. Coincidental. Them go so boom now and it's like, yeah, man, look for you. I don't know if jokes, boy, but no, top jokes, man.
Yeah,
I don't know if I tell them quarter tea and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But Bojo did a youth a Lexus. And he's only after him going to prison for the joke, man. That I say, look like him never get no cash, you know. Charles like his own. Yeah. It's only after him gone pick myself, but look like that time is never money. They would give me drugs. That's what I said to myself.
Mm-hmm.
But then after a while, they pick up certain things and say, well, that man involved in that. So anyway, me and Dodger gonna say, because what had happened about 3 or 4 days before, me used to go for sell a vehicle. Yeah. You know, like a thief in my exile. We used to go to prison every minute. Yes, man.
Remember him.
Yeah.
Hey, that brother, I'm supposed to dead still now, you know?
I'm dead, man. I'm dead, and I have a brain tumor.
Oh, that man, the thief, man. The thief, man, you know, man.
That man, the time I'm dead, he's still a policeman in Portland.
Mm.
Up out of the highest bus. And may I have to end up over the bus. And they did have a payment thing, and you have a payment of the money. So I'm just telling you, you know what? Just give my father the rest of the money. I'm going to get
the bus
certified company, because the man done dead and gone already and thing. So, and they did turn brain to you, my man.
Well, hey, that man, I'll bet on the teeth, man.
Yeah, man.
Hey, and he never have no conscience to him, man. Every minute him that quoted.
No, you have no conscience, man.
Yeah, man.
Around 50, and as it, they catch up with him, and just move the camera down on this.
Yeah, true, man.
Them couldn't hide from.
That's true, man. He was anyway, Steve,
so
man.
The day, you know, they used it, we still don't know now when they would come buy a car.
Mm.
I hear the name, just observing, I hear the name. I hear the address.
Mm-hmm.
So, the day when Dadrick and they come run an auto vision, and I say, my car was seized from exit name over Pokemon, but I'm doing it with the address there.
Yeah, so we have come to the end of this part, you know, Butch Banton, you know, show, you know, he's such an evil man that, you know, he took his dog even to the vet to have an abortion because he hated his neighbor. And we are the Jamaica Young Police Channel say, you know, the man is a jerk, you know, how you to do that? You know, a life, it doesn't really matter what kind of life. A dog life is still a life on them thing. Oh, on God's earth, you take a dog to have a abortion. Come on, man. You're supposed to respect life. Remember, you know, a dog is a blessing from God to you. Because man cannot create dog. We can't create life. You know, so I'm going to show you that's how this man have little or no regard to the sanctity of life, irrespective, even a dog. Oh, on God's earth, you do something like that. But, you know, to show you that the man is callous. Look what the man have done. The man have a woman who have 5 kids for him. And the man went to Africa and married to another woman and returned to Jamaica as if it was nothing. And if it wasn't being the man who went to Africa and wanted to marry to the same woman and realized that the woman was Butch Banton's wife, Lana would not know that this man was married. What an evil man, and he lived with the woman. But such is life. But Butch Banton must remember that in life, no sins go unpunished. You will have to pay for all the crimes that you have committed in life. And I just say, go, real mama, papa, true that, and you know that too. So all of them lives that you are destroyed, remember, you know, your day is coming. Yeah, man, every dog have its day and every puss have its 4 o'clock. Have yourself a beautiful day. Jamaica, Young Police Channel. And before we conclude, yeah, part 4 will be coming up next. So we in the same time tomorrow, and we won't hold back against our loyal viewers and subscribers. You have a beautiful day. Jamaica Young Police Channel out.